Sunday night in Anaheim, Dallas forward Ryan Garbutt skated across the ice and launched himself into Anaheim forward Dustin Penner, delivering a blow to the head that caused a serious injury. As the video shows, Penner is working the puck off the wall in the Dallas zone as Garbutt approaches from the opposite side of the ice. After Penner makes a pass, Garbutt, having traveled a distance, launches himself up and into Penner. This is charging. Having just left the penalty box, Garbutt enters his own team's zone to take up his defensive position. As he sees Penner beat his man off the wall and cut to the middle, Garbutt, who is gliding, shuffles his skates in order to pick up speed. He then clearly leaps into his check, causing his own head to crash into Penner's head and turning what might have been a full body check into a violent and dangerous hit. To summarize, this was charging. Garbutt has no history of supplemental discipline in his 64-game NHL career. Penner suffered a serious injury as a result of this hit. The Department of Player Safety has suspended Ryan Garbutt for 5 games.
So that's huge for secondary scoring in the early going for Pete DeBoer and the New Jersey Devils as two Panthers collide, and that's a vicious collision between Kopeski and Madden. The former Devil is down and he's in pain, but play continues. Zidlitsky is stopped by Theodore. Madden is trying to crawl on his hands and knees. Oh my.
What a shock to the system here for the Florida Panthers, and obviously a really tough situation here for John Madden. He and Kopetsky going in opposite directions. I could feel the collision from here. Look at that. I mean, he has his head down. He's not expecting anybody to come at him from that direction. Kopetsky seemed to be looking at the play, and they both zigged when they should have zagged. And Madden never knew any. I saw pieces of Madden's helmet chip off and fly off. And he just went down, and he barely moved, except he's in obvious pain there. It's hard to tell from here where exactly he's cut, but obviously he's cut pretty badly. But the collision force of it just totally shocked and stunned his whole body. Here comes Madden from the right side. And you know what? It's head on head. I mean, the helmet of Kopetsky. It looks like the nose. But Kopetsky's head, oh my goodness, I don't recall ever seeing a collision exactly like that, especially two guys on the same team.
We had one of those last night in the power play. Oh, and then he just hit Oshie hard.
And Ovechkin's hurt. He and Oshie just ran into each other.
Coming up, Oshie's turning the other way. Let's watch his face.
Oh wow, is that a hard collision? Head to head, and it looks on the bench at any rate that Ovechkin's okay, and so is Oshie.
Yeah, and the last thing Oshie wants to do is hurt his own guy, but look at Oshie's head's down, and oh yeah, just right on the shoulder. And Jim, this is one where would you not look at concussion protocol?
For both of them?
Yeah, for both of them. He's getting a little talking to you. See the right of your screen there. Yeah, are you okay? I'm wondering if concussion spotters are maybe pulling him off. You know, you don't want the head coach to have to worry about it because he's coaching. So the trainer comes in. They've had the call down to the bench, and he's got to go explain, say, I know you're feeling okay, Alexander, but I got to take you out of here.
Niederreiter to Haula, who carries in. Haula works his way to the net on the backhand. And a save by Lettinen, and then Haula. We'll hear about this one as he collides with the Dallas goaltender.
Did he ever steamroll Lettinen on the end of that play? Steamrolled. Watch Haula go to the net. And he just keeps going. Looks like he lost an edge right as he got to the net. But he did not make any effort to get out of the way. Oh, looked like the back of his foot got hooked a little bit on the defenseman as well. But either way, he ends up just bulldozing Lettinen, cuts him because of the impact. Lettinen is out of the game, and Haula gets a 5-minute major and a game misconduct for charging their goaltender. Watch how Haula gets tripped up here. His left skate and then his right skate gets hooked. And then he kind of loses his balance and goes right into Lettinen. He had a lot of speed.
Nate Gensel with Crosby. Late man Letang, all kinds of space, still holds, unable to get a shot off. Letty was down along the ice.
And a big collision here, guys. Barzal, two Islanders collided here. The net was off at one end. The referee allowed it to go so the Penguins could score. And then we saw Tavares and Barzal running into each other as Barzal was trying to get back into the play. That was a pretty good collision.
Watches Barzal, and John Tavares is not looking. Oh, boy. Tavares takes that right on the chin. Let's hope he's okay.
Knocked down before any shot could be taken. Lowry after it. Knocked his man into the boards behind the net. The net is off, and the goalie appears to be hurt. Michael Hutchinson down and in pain.
Well, he got absolutely run over on this play, Ed. Bork went to the net, took the puck to the net, and then was pushed in. And Michael Hutchinson, I don't know, like, he looks like he certainly hit his head on this play as his mask came off, and he is certainly feeling the effects of it at the moment.
In the runway is Pavlik, and he's wondering if he's coming in. Here's what happened.
And Adam, oh yeah, head to head. Basically, they knocked heads.
Front to Greg Patterson. He was met by Udon, followed that up, and got cranked. He was in a tough spot. Andrew Shaw came in and pasted him.
I think he took the worst of it.
Shaw did, yes.
Yes, he did. He took the worst of that. When he ran into Greg Patterson, their heads may have collided. I think he actually gave him a bit of a shove and a punch here right at the end of it, but Shaw was already down and out, and it looked like it was head on head as they collided. Patterson doesn't pick it up right at the end. Shaw got his shoulder right under the chin of Greg Patterson, and as he's laying down on the ice, Patterson's ready to go back at him, doesn't realize that it looks like Shaw is actually out on his feet after taking that, or actually delivering that hit.
Greg Patterson is a large lad. He's 6'3", 225.
Now it looks like it's 44.
Perhaps closing in on 50 hits.
Yeah. 44-26.
Shaw is up and getting help from teammates and medical staff.
Corey Krug. He got the lone assist on the Pasternak goal. Dylan DeMello. Looks like there's an injury here. They're calling for the training staff immediately.
I'm not sure what happened, but Backus, I think, hit him on the play, and there's obviously some serious concern.
Some of the Senators now coming over.
The whole team now
want to see their teammate.
So hard on everybody involved, obviously, from both sides, as most of the players now are over, as you can see. And here go the Boston Bruin team over also. Here they go. Each and every player.
Oh. Nobody ever wants to see a player injured. Both teams over. As Scott Sabourin is being removed from the ice.
Every player concerned and over there.